The Hydrologic Ensemble Forecast Service, or HEFS, produces ensemble streamflow forecasts that account for both meteorological as well as hydrological uncertainty. HEFS uses the Meteorological Ensemble Forecast Processor, or MEFP, to produce an ensemble of meteorological forcing data for hydrological modeling. The hydrological model then produces an ensemble streamflow forecast that accounts for the meteorological uncertainty. Next, the HEFS uses a component called the Ensemble Post Processor, or EnsPost.
The EnsPost adjusts an ensemble of streamflow forecasts to account for the hydrological modeling uncertainties and to correct for biases that are caused by the hydrological modeling. The end product is an ensemble of adjusted streamflow forecasts that are less biased and properly account for the uncertainties in the hydrological modeling.
EnsPost has two steps. The first involves building a representation of historical hydrological uncertainty and bias.
The first step involves learning from the past. In this step, the EnsPost looks at the accuracy of the hydrological modeling over a long historical period and attempts to learn from this information.
This second step involves adjusting the current ensemble streamflow forecast based on this representation of the historical information.
In other words, past hydrological modeling errors are a guide to future hydrological modeling errors.
EnsPost uses three pieces of historical information to build a representation of historical hydrological bias and uncertainty for each river basin. The first two are the simulated and observed streamflow. The historical simulated streamflow is a model-generated approximation of streamflow produced for many years. This simulation uses observed temperature and precipitation as inputs. This is in contrast to a forecast streamflow, which uses forecast temperature and precipitation as inputs. The simulated streamflow is produced using the same hydrological model used to produce the ensemble streamflow forecasts. Therefore, the difference between the historical simulated streamflow and observed streamflow represents a hydrological model error. This error may stem from anywhere in the hydrological modeling, such as the runoff, soil moisture, or routing parameters. This provides the first part of the representation of hydrological bias and uncertainty. The third piece of information we need to represent historical hydrological bias and uncertainty is a prior observation carried forward in time. We refer to this as a persisted observation. This is analogous to a persistence forecast. EnsPost uses the persisted observation to reduce the uncertainty in its final adjusted streamflow, since streamflow often persists in time, particularly at low flows or in slow-responding river basins. Now let's walk through an example of how EnsPost uses these three pieces of information to build a representation of historical hydrological bias and uncertainty. For the time of interest in our example, we can plot a point in 3D space that represents the values for the historical simulated streamflow, the persisted streamflow observation, and the observed streamflow. Now, if we repeat this process for all of the times in a streamflow simulation, we see the relationship between these three variables represented by a cloud of points. We use a different cloud of points for different seasons, different river basins, and for low versus high flows. To make use of this cloud of points, we fit a plane to it in the 3D space. This is analogous to a best fit line through a 2D scatter plot, but here we have three variables rather than two. The plane is used to predict the observed streamflow based on the simulated streamflow and the persisted observation. This will be used to account for bias. The scatter of the cloud of points around the plane represents the uncertainty. So now we have a historical representation of hydrological bias and uncertainty. The second step in the EnsPost process is to adjust the ensemble streamflow forecast based on this historical representation together with the current persisted observation.
This second step will adjust for bias and combine the meteorological uncertainty generated by MEFP with the hydrological uncertainty produced by EnsPost.
To illustrate how EnsPost does this, let's walk through the process for a single member of the ensemble streamflow forecast at multiple lead times. To produce an adjusted streamflow forecast at a 6-hour lead time, ensemble first uses the streamflow forecast at 6 hours, and the persisted observation carried forward from the prior observation 6 hours earlier. Now we will bring back our historical representation of hydrological bias and uncertainty to be combined with current information. We assume that the current streamflow forecast is analogous to our simulated streamflow. For now, we will set aside the scatter of points and come back to it later to address uncertainty. We assume the historical observed streamflow is analogous to the current adjusted streamflow forecast. Now we use the plane as a guide to get a forecast adjusted for the persisted observation and bias. This provides ensemble with an initial adjusted forecast of the streamflow at 6 hours. In our example, this is 9 CFS. In doing this, ensemble has now used the historical representation to adjust for bias and assimilate the persisted observation with the current streamflow forecast. For the final operation to adjust the forecast at this time step, ensemble returns to the scatter of points around the plane to account for hydrological uncertainty. Recall that this scatter represents the historical uncertainty from the hydrological model. ensemble samples this uncertainty and combines this with the adjusted forecast to make a final adjustment to the forecast value. For example, if we adjust our previous forecast of 11 CFS for uncertainty based on the cloud, we get a final adjusted streamflow forecast at 6 hours of 12 CFS. Next, we need an adjusted streamflow forecast at 12 hours. Since we do not have a prior observation at 6 hours, we use our adjusted forecast at that time and persist that forward to 12 hours. ensemble combines this persisted observation from 6 hours with the streamflow forecast at 12 hours, repeating the process to produce the adjusted forecast at 12 hours. This is repeated for all time steps to generate a complete adjusted streamflow forecast. The entire process is then repeated for each ensemble member, culminating in an adjusted ensemble streamflow forecast. This wraps up step 2.
The end product is an ensemble of adjusted streamflow forecasts that are less biased and properly account for the uncertainties in the hydrological modeling.
By adjusting an ensemble streamflow forecast to account for past hydrological prediction quality, ensemble helps HEFS provide a more reliable streamflow forecast to support impact-based decision-making. Implementation of ensemble currently varies by location, so consult with your regional river forecast center for information on if and how it is used in your local HEFS forecast.